It is Super Draco 380, and we're back with another episode of the Bismarck. Today we're going to be doing stage 12, the gearbox for the forward gun turret. First things first, we got this big cog. Now there's an arrow on the big cog that my camera was having a hard time picking up, and that arrow is going to point towards the bow of the ship. So you want pointing that way. And easy enough, it just fits right into the barbette right there. So then we're going to flip it over. And we're going to actually mount the gun to it. So we bring in the gun, feed through that wire for the gun's motor, and it's just going to drop right in. Whoops. So then just reorient the cog where the arrow is pointing towards the bow of the ship. And we're going to be fitting that with two PB screws. However, in this kit, there's actually different PB screws. There's the 2.3 by 6 millimeter and then the 2 by 6 millimeter. So we're using the wider PB screws. So as you can see, I'm just checking which ones are the big ones. And just going to squeeze them out. Load up the first one, and we're going to start screwing it in. And with that done, next we're going to start building the gears for the elevation of the gun. So we're going to bring in the housing for the gearbox. First things first, we need this small cog to fit into that hole right there. Now there's going to be one side that has teeth and then the other side that is facing down out of the housing is going to mesh with a motor. So next we bring in the big cog. For some reason, my camera's having a bit of a hard time focusing. I'm guessing maybe it's the black mat plus my light. So this is going to be held in with a 2x6mm PB screw. And you just want that set in there so the gears can rotate like that. And then what you're going to do is there's that peg on the large gear. This little arm you want sticking out the bottom, and you want the arch in it, or the angled piece, pointing towards the rounded part. And then we have two more little pins. The first witch. That one had a curled end, so instead we're going to be using the smooth pin. So we're just going to use the tweezers. Drop that in. Then we're going to close it up. And then we're going to seal it up with four more 2x6 millimeter PB screws. And what we're going to do is we're going to fix the gearbox into that shaft on the bottom of the gun. And we're going to use that curled pin to do so. And just judging from the angles of all this, if that sounds like it's going to be pain in the neck, you are quite right. Now, honestly, I don't know why this step wasn't done before mounting the gun in. Because I would figure you could attach this, get it all nice and mounted, and then put the gun on the ship. So what's going to happen is that's going to fit like so. And I'm using my fingers to elevate the gun so it is far out of the ship as I can. And I'm trying to get the curled end with my tweezers so that I can just drop it in like so, shove it in, and there's part of the way in. What I actually did is shoved it all the way through. So we're going to try again. We're just trying to get it in the hole. So basically, once I get the pin in, and then I just used my tweezers to tap it in, now it's held in, and you can see this is elevating the barrels of the Bismarck's gun. So when connected, that little cross-shaped motor will rotate, elevating and the Bismarck's gun. Alright, and that'll wrap up stage 12. We'll be back for stage 13, the hinge supports for the breakwater. Thanks for watching.